Whoever wanted one moment to capture, just let it slip. Yo, his palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous. But on the surface,
I'm gonna start dancing.
He did drop palms, but he keeps on forgetting what he wrote.
Oh, it doesn't take much.
But the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's choking now. The clock's run out. Time's up. Over. Glass. Snap back to reality. Oh, there goes gravity. Oh, there goes gravity. Choke. He's so mad, but he won't give up. That is he know. He won't have it. He knows. It's all back to these ropes. It don't matter. He's dope. He knows that, but he's broke. He's so stacked that he knows. And he goes back to this mobile home. That's when it's back to the lab again. Yo, this old capsule. He better go capture this moment and hope it don't.
Give you guys a little taste of my morning. Whenever I really, really want to just go all out, I'm like, where's the 8 Mile soundtrack? It's my jam. Okay, so thanks for jumping on. Today, I really wanted to kind of dig into a couple of the core lessons that we were going over this last weekend when I went to Brendon Burchard's High Performance Academy. It was amazing. If you guys have never been to an event like that, Stephanie, who's on, was with me, and then Joelle was with me as well. It was literally life-changing. A lot of this stuff, for me, is stuff that I've been hardcore learning over the years. I've been to several of his events, but as he says over and over and over, in the event, common knowledge is not always common practice. So I was just so thankful that I signed up for that event and kind of just just sat again with a lot of that information and thought, like, why did I get out of the habit of thinking that way or doing things in a certain way? So I want to talk a little bit about some of just a couple, I mean, like 4 days of content, we've got an hour. So I'm going to go over just a couple things that I felt can help you guys the most in your business today. And one of the books that he recommended, that every time he'd say a book, I'd be like on my Amazon app and be like, ooh, one click order, one click order. I came home to like 4 new books sitting in my mailbox. One of the books was called Flow. I'm not even going to begin to try to pronounce or spell this guy's last name. It's all like random letters. But if you guys look for that book that looks like this on Amazon, it's called Flow, The Psychology of Optimal Experience. And I grabbed this for my personal development this morning and highlighted a couple sentences or paragraphs that really aligned with what I wanted to teach this morning. So one of them was, hold on, let me close my door because my dog's gonna freak. One of them was, the best moments usually occur when a person's body or mind is stretched to the limits in a voluntary effort to accomplish something difficult or worthwhile. So a lot of what this book is talking about is people search for happiness, why a lot of people don't feel happy on a regular basis, what's the trick. And then another one that I highlighted was, don't aim at success. The more you aim at it and make it a target, the more you're going to miss it. Hold on, let me just go ahead and mute everybody. Okay. Blair, whenever you want to jump in, just unmute yourself. Okay, let me start over. Don't aim at success. The more you aim at it and make it a target, the more you're going to miss it. For success, like happiness, cannot be pursued. It must ensue as the unintended side effect of one's personal dedication to a course greater than oneself. And I was like, geez, this is like perfect for what we do as coaches, because number one, this is hard shit. I'm not going to like sit. You guys know that. We talk about that all the time. If it were easy, everybody would be rich, right? And clearly that's not the case. There's a small percentage of people that actually make it big in this business. And I have been studying so hard what's that difference so that I can share that with you guys. And you guys should be looking for those clues. We were talking about this on the leaders page this morning. Success leaves clues. So what are they? So constantly studying people who are at a higher level than us, who've done something that we want to do, who have already walked the course that we want to walk, and how did they do it? How did they think differently? And really it all comes down to how we approach life through our thoughts. And that's why we talk about mindset all the time. And sometimes it can feel like it's just like the number one topic of conversation, but that's because the only thing that keeps you guys stuck is what happens between these 2 ears. So I feel like the more we talk about it, the more that we can break it down and give you guys a clear action plan of how to approach your day. It will help you guys feel more confident in how you're approaching your business. And it really comes down to the day to today. So let me just, I'm going to read the definition that Brendan gave us this weekend. And he said the definition of a high performer. He said a high performer excels beyond standard norms consistently. He made us bold and underline that over the long term. And I think we talk about consistency all the time. And the first thing that I ask a coach when they come to me and they say, I'm struggling, this just isn't working for me. I was talking to one of my girls yesterday. And from the conversations we were having online, it seemed like she was doing everything. Like, but then when we got on the phone and I actually started asking her some key questions, I realized there were a lot of really significant vital behaviors that she was not doing on a consistent basis, and consistency will make or break you. So why we use that word all the time, it's because it's so significant, and repetition is the mother of all skills. So if we're not consistently working our business, if sometimes we show up on social media, we lose our momentum and we lose trust from the people who are following us because we're not consistently there for them. So that's why social media is so important, consistently sharing your results, that vital behavior of being a product to the product. You've got to actually show people that you're doing that. That's why social media is all about being consistent. So then Brendan went ahead and broke down high performance living. Now this is how you guys actually approach your day if you're gonna be a high performer. If you guys want to achieve all the things that you have written down on your vision board from this year. I know we talk all the time, it's talked a lot about, especially on the news, like people, you know, they start a new fitness program, the gyms explode with new attendance for the first like 3 weeks in the year, and then all of a sudden it starts to phase out again. And it's that small percentage of people that are committed to the high performance living that are going to continue to maintain that and be consistent over time. You guys have to make that conscious decision to be disciplined. And for me, the word discipline used to give me like the heebie-jeebies, because I'm like, I'm a free spirit. I don't want to be disciplined. Like I want to come and go as I please, and I want to do everything what I want when I want. And while that's true, it was reaffirmed to me that discipline in my business actually gives me more freedom. And I had to start looking at that word with a positive and really embracing it and wanting to feel disciplined every day. And that small mindset shift literally was probably the most profound change for me in that event, because like I really, really had a disdained hate relationship with the word discipline until now. Okay, so high performance living is defined the ongoing feeling of full engagement, joy, and confidence that comes from consistently living your best self. So how do you guys approach that in your business? This that you guys have heard me talk for the last like year and a half, bring the joy. Joy was my word of the year last year because I started feeling like a stressed, hot mess success train the year prior to that, because I was all over the place in my business. I was taking on too much and I was starting to burn out. And I realized I don't want to live like that anymore. So number one, whatever I do, I'm going to do it with joy. I teach that to my children when they have to clean their bedrooms. If you're going to do it with what? And they say, joy, mommy. And I approach my business and things, even the pieces of my business that I don't necessarily love, with joy. And the last one is confidence. So full engage, let me just go ahead and break these down. Full engagement is living full out, meaning you are fucking hungry for success. Like, you want it more than you want to eat, sleep, and breathe. You guys have probably seen some amazing inspirational YouTube videos kind of on that topic of like, where you have to almost feel like you're suffocating. You want it so bad to where you are fully engaged into your business. And this, for me, as I study other top coaches, this was a huge success leaves clues impression on me, because I looked at how they approached their business and it was almost like they were so obsessed with it, the way that some people are obsessed with Netflix. Netflix is a distraction. Not saying like don't enjoy a good show once in a while, but do it not as a distraction. So fully engaging in your business and just going all out. No matter what it takes, I'm hungry for success. I'm going to do whatever it takes. I'm going to be teachable. I'm going to be honest with myself and recognize when I'm not being teachable and when I'm blocking myself. And then doing it with joy. This was where I started to actually decline in my business. I had that like year to 18 months where I was struggling so hard. We've talked about this many times on team calls where I was just in that constant comparison game, that jealousy game of feeling not good enough. And that's where all my focus goes, and where your focus goes, or what you focus on, expands. So I was focusing my attention on jealousy, and that was the only thing that was expanding in my business. My business was not moving forward. Once I came back and started approaching my every single conversation that I was having with a potential customer and being fully present and fully engaged with them, and doing that with joy, so much that the results were just explosively different. And my business has never declined like that again. It's only been straight shot upwards because I had full engagement of being teachable and giving my business my everything. That doesn't mean all your time, but when you are giving your business your time, you're giving it your everything. 100% joy. And then the last one is confidence. And I know a lot of people struggle with this, but when you guys are focused with worry of not being good enough, we were talking about this last night, that's really just a distraction for you to not move forward in your business. We all feel a little bit of fear in our business. It's those people who feel the fear and do it anyway that are going to see their businesses move forward. Confidence is something that you have to make an active choice. We do not have confidence. We choose to generate confidence. That is a choice. It's not a birthright. So if you guys are like, oh, I'm just not a confident person, that's because you haven't made the choice to teach yourself how to be more confident. That's a skill, and it's an active choice to generate confidence in who you are on a daily basis. We're all going to have those moments where we start to lack a little bit of confidence. It still happens to me, but I have to make that choice to generate confidence in myself. Whenever I stand on a stage and I do public speaking, where once upon a time, I would have never volunteered to do public speaking ever. I did it because my job required me to. My boss pushed me in a boardroom in front of a bunch of men that all flew in on their private jets. That was the most intimidating experience probably of my professional life. I was forced to do it, and it traumatized me. The fact that now I choose to stand on stage is only because I made a conscious choice to build my confidence. And the confidence comes from action. It comes from doing. It comes from full engagement of feeling that fear and then taking the plunge. It's like pulling the Band-Aid. You pull it off and all of a sudden it's like, ooh, that hurt a little bit, but not so bad. And it's better now. That's really kind of the way that we grow. We get a little uncomfortable. We try something and realize, holy crap, number one, I didn't die. And number two, that wasn't so bad. And sometimes we actually even enjoyed it. And now I'm to the point where I still get nervous before I public speak, but I actually really enjoy it because I realize like it's such a special platform for me to use my God-given gifts of teaching so that I can help improve other people's lives. And now it's become more of an act of service than me avoiding it because of fear of judgment or fear of failure. So those three words, engagement, joy, and confidence. If you guys picked three words that you could focus on and just embrace on a daily basis, set up an alarm on your phone several times a day that say, feel full engagement, joy, and confidence in my business today. Say it in the present. I feel full engagement, joy, and confidence in my business or life. This is so good for relationships too. Engagement, joy, and confidence in relationships. How often do we have fights with our spouses because we are lacking confidence in ourselves? Like, oh, he probably doesn't think that I'm very beautiful because we don't think we're beautiful and we project that on them. So our lower or lack of confidence creates frustration in our relationships, especially for women. So you have to make that conscious decision to be confident in relationships, in your business on a daily basis. Okay. So those are the three things, the three words that I want to talk about just as far as how you guys can approach your business. Now let me get into some fun stuff. I thought it was fun at least because I'm a psychology nerd, but so he got into some details about the form of persuasion. And I love this word because I can use these skill sets to help people overcome their fears. I don't use persuasion to get what I want. I use persuasion to help other people have the courage to embrace what they want. So I just wanted to be clear about that. So as you guys are posting on social media, these are some things that you guys can think about that are going to give you influence and then are going to help you guys be a little bit more persuasive, especially in conversations where you're inviting people to learn more about the business or about the challenge group. So number one, you guys always want to be framing things in the positive. Your energy dictates the outcome. So here's where joy kind of pops back into it. If your mind is focused when you're having a one-on-one conversation with a potential coach or a potential customer, and your focus is on, they're probably going to think this is too expensive. You're in a lower energy right now because that energy is you're projecting fear of them saying no. Now, if your energy is in the positive, and you're thinking, they're going to love this. This is going to help them so much. They already told me that their problems are X, Y, Z. And I know that this program or this opportunity is going to be so good for them. That confidence and that positive energy oftentimes will dictate your outcome. And sometimes you might still hear the word no, but that's not because you did something wrong. That's because they just weren't ready and it wasn't their time. And that's okay. That has nothing to do with you. It has to do with it being the right timing for them. But we're going to talk a little bit about how sometimes people still say no, and it's not because it's not the right time. It's just because they're scared that they're going to fail and how you guys can project your confidence onto them and help them overcome that. The next thing to think about is people's intrinsic priorities and their extrinsic priorities. So basically what that means is intrinsic, it has to do with more of the inner fulfillment. What is meaningful to them? So let's think about the fact that the business opportunity, the community that we have, the fact that we get to wake up every single morning, have coffee with our kids sitting on our lap, listening to Gangster Rap, like that's kind of cool. That's like a fulfilling community feel where we get that. We get other people investing into us and where we have the opportunity to invest into other people. It feels good. It's very fulfilling to us. Extrinsic would be more along the lines of like the status that they might get, money, power, winning. People who are very competitive like those words, power and winning. But a lot of times when people crave money or power to win, it's because they think that having those things is going to bring them happiness. So really the extrinsic things support that inner need to feel fulfilled and happy. It's just that most people believe that's what it's going to take for them to be happy. So you being able to bounce between the two of maybe you're writing a business opportunity post and you're inviting people to learn more about the team, how is this going to fulfill their inner needs? And how is it also going to fulfill their extrinsic needs of status, money, power, more freedom of time, stuff like that? So you guys constantly see me posting about freedom of time, freedom of finances, location freedom. Those are all things that are really, really important to me. So I post about them quite a bit. I don't post about power because that's not something that I care about. But some people do care about status. They want the opportunity to have a business that makes them feel like they have status. Now, sometimes when it comes to a network marketing opportunity, the status piece can feel disempowering because people might go from like, oh, I actually am a doctor or I'm a nurse, and now you want me to claim myself as a network marketer? That seems like a loss of status to some people. For me, I feel like I elevated my status because I have more freedom to go do the things that are really important to me. So it's all perspective, right? The next one is being able to extend the benefits of this business beyond the person you're talking to. So this is called benefit extension. But what I mean by that is you need to go beyond their personal wants and desires, and you need to explain how it's going to benefit the people in their environment. Maybe that's their children. Maybe that's their spouse. One of the examples that he gave us, he said, let's say you're talking to your son and your son doesn't want to do his math homework. He just told you, sorry, mom, don't want to do my math homework today. So the mom could say, I'll use my son's name, for example, since that is that relates to me. I say, Jackson, I know sometimes homework isn't your favorite thing, but you're so smart. I know you don't like doing some of this stuff, and I know you're tired. You don't like your teacher, but your mom has a request. If you did it, it's not just that you would feel better. You'd do better in life, but also Madison, your sister's watching how you do your homework. Did you notice that your teacher is nice to you when you do your homework? I bet Madison's teacher would be nice to her too, huh? If you're showing her the good example. So that would be like an example of benefit extension that you guys can use to persuade your children to do their homework. Let's use this in business. We can use the example of moms because this is where I'm really passionate. How we treat our bodies and how we treat ourselves teaches our children how to do the same thing. And so when we are stress eating and constantly drinking, and eating foods that leave us feeling lethargic, really like lacking energy, lacking mental clarity, lacking focus, not wanting to take our kids to the playground because we're exhausted after a long day. Who wants to go on a walk with the dog and the kids after working, you know, a long day? You were up at 5 a.m., but your kids are watching and you're teaching them how to rock life. And right now through your example, you might be teaching them that it's okay to just come home and binge watch Netflix. Do you guys know that the average person wastes like 13 years of their life watching TV? Isn't that disgusting? It's crazy. Is that what we want our children? So that's a benefit extension. It's like, what are you teaching your children and how do you want to help them elevate and be successful in their life? It's not about what we say, it's about what we do. So that's a form of benefit extension. Or teaching them to go after their dreams, what it might be business related, where if we're afraid to just go all out and succeed wildly in our business, we're teaching our children not to go after their dreams too, based off of our behavior. So that's another benefit extension of just showing like, I'm going to show up. I'm going to do the work. I'm going to do it fully engaged with joy and confidence. How is that going to translate to our kids or to our husband, right? Maybe he's not going after his dreams and it's just become part of family culture and it's okay now. Okay. The last one is daily reality. So successful, truly wildly successful people in business don't just sell features and benefits of like a fitness program or Shakeology. They sell the dream. They sell ambition. They sell how their daily lives can be made better. So if you can learn to paint the picture through your social media posts of how someone's daily life can be improved through this business, this is something that I have been working on this craft for the last like 2.5 years, really solidly, of learning how to be a really powerful storyteller. And ultimately what I'm doing is I am painting a picture of what someone's daily life can be like if their reality is changed from where it is right now. So maybe when it comes to the products, you're painting the picture of having energy. You're painting the picture of having confidence. That smile, you guys, your actual before after pictures, like the inches lost, are not as powerful as the smile and the confidence that reads on your face. You guys may have only lost maybe, I don't like to use the word only, you may have lost 5 inches. And sometimes that can feel, wow, I put 30 days into this. That doesn't feel like a lot because we're comparing ourselves to other people's results instead of owning ourselves. But the difference between one person not feeling good about that and the next person who said, I did lose 5 inches, and that smile and that excitement, that joy, that translates really, really well to other people. Other people look at your confidence and they see you being so happy and they're like, I want that in my daily life. I'm tired of going to bed feeling regretful, feeling down on myself. I want confidence. I want to crawl into bed and feel proud. Feel like I worked hard today and I earned this rest. So that could be a way of painting the daily reality change. I do this all the time through my freedom posts since I've been blessed enough to walk away from my full-time job. Or if you guys are able, maybe you're a stay-at-home mom and you didn't have to walk away from a job, but now you are at home. I look at this business for a stay-at-home mom as having your cake and eating it too, because we need to invest ourselves into something so beautiful and something that really truly elevates our own lives and other people, and we don't have to sacrifice our children to do it. That's very special. So I paint that life all the time. Last night I was doing a little bit of work before bed and sitting outside on the patio, and my daughter came up and curled with me and she was working on some stuff too. And we just sat there and worked together, and then we'd stop and play and have conversations. And I had the freedom to still be present with her while I was getting some work done. And it was so joyful. And I thought, man, like, you can't do that in a corporate office, right? Except for the one day a year where it's like, take your kids to work day. That's not the reality. And every single day when my daughter walks through the door, I throw down everything that I'm doing and I meet her with a smile and a huge hug and tell her how much I missed her. And I could not do that. And I'm still to this day so grateful that when she walks through the door, I'm here. I get to listen to her. If she had a rough day, I get to hear about it. And I get to be present with her and give her advice and whatever. And then I'll go back and finish up my work and she goes and does her homework. But I'm here and I get to welcome her back into my life every single day. Or getting to take a day off and go on a field trip. Stuff, just little things that I wasn't able to do before. So those are the ways that you guys can paint without having any success in this business. You guys don't have to be making the big bucks. So can you guys hear me okay? This is my internet connection is unstable. Yeah, shake your head, someone. Yeah, okay. Just making sure. I don't know what's up with my internet today. Okay. So here's the last couple of tips for you guys. Here's how you guys can have influence with other people. Influence first starts with confidence. If you guys are confident in the products and the opportunity that you have to sell, and if you're confident in your ability to learn to be a better leader, that's where you guys can gain confidence. That's why it's so important to use the products, because we can't have confidence in something that we don't believe in using ourselves. And therefore, we can't move our business forward. It's not because we need those Success Club points in order to hit Success Club. It's because I need my coaches to have confidence in our products and our opportunity in order for them to actually succeed in this business that they just signed up for. That's so important. But next is, you guys need to be a confident thought leader. Teach people how to think. I'm doing that with you right now. I take my personal development, and you guys could take a book like this and take one sentence like the don't aim at success. The more you aim at it and make it a target, the more you're going to miss it. For success, like happiness, cannot be pursued. It must be ensued. Teach people how to go all out for their dreams. I can take that small little piece of personal development that I just learned today and go reteach it through social media. I do this all the time. And that makes me a thought leader. It is allowing me to teach other people how to think, which elevates my influence. You guys can do this too. And then challenge people and push them. When you challenge people and push them, this gives you more influence. A lot of people are a little scared to challenge people and say, you can do better. I know that you can elevate yourself more, and say like, I know you did not show up and go all out today in your business. You can do this better. For you to challenge people and push them, to challenge their character and say you're better than that, gives you influence, because you're only saying, if you're doing that with the approach of truly trying to serve them and help make them better. Challenge their connections, like for example, you're an amazing mom. For you to not take care of yourself today is you saying that you don't believe that. You need to show your children that you can do better. And for you to challenge people like that, it actually builds trust. It can be scary at first, the first time. And that's what I was talking before about when sometimes people say no to, for example, a challenge group. And sometimes it's just because they're not ready. But sometimes they are ready. They're just still a little scared. And that's your opportunity to rise up as an influential leader and say, and challenge them and say, no, you're better than that. You just told me. I'm sick of doing XYZ. I'm sick of having this in my life. I want this XYZ. Are you doing this out of fear because you're not going to succeed? Because I'm here and I'm going to make sure that you show up every day. That's my job as a coach. Or do you really not have the money? Because a lot of times, like when people are motivated, they'll move mountains to find the money, right? We all know that because we've been there. When it's been like a serious situation, we're like, crap, I need money for this. We find it. We go sell something out of our garage. Boom, money in our pockets, right? I've seen people pawn wedding rings to sign up for their business, go make the money, and then purchase their wedding ring back. That's motivated. So people will find a way if it's important enough. You have to have the confidence to challenge them and to push them to be better. And the last one is challenge people's contributions. So this goes back to a little bit of challenging again, but saying like, you can give more. I know you showed up today, but I know that you got distracted playing in your Facebook newsfeed. I know that you binge watched Netflix for 3 hours. You can give more to your business, or help people find room in their schedule to work out. We all have the same 24 hours in a day, right? Why is it that J-Lo can have the schedule that she has and the body that she has? If she can do it, right? I look at that woman, I'm like, she's like a beast with her schedule. It's so inspiring, because like, I read this amazing article about how she wakes up in the morning, she meditates, she works out, she does meetings, she spends time with her kids, XYZ, and I'm just like, she's got to have a secret to like time warping or something like that. But really, that's an excuse. we all have the same 24 hours. If J-Lo can do it, we can do it. It's a matter of choice and motivation. So you challenging people's ability to contribute to their day more, to give more to their business, to give more focus to give more focus to their relationships when they're supposed to be present with them, to give more focus to their business when they're supposed to be present with their business. So you guys have to be willing to step up as that leader and to challenge people's contributions, challenge them to show up, push them, and to teach them how to think. Those are just a few ways that you guys can increase the amount of influence and work. And when you start to have influence like that, people listen to you and they trust you so much faster. Okay, that's all I'm going to share with you guys today because I want to make sure to have time for questions. And if you guys are like at all curious about some of the stuff that I've learned, like put it on your calendar to go to the next High Performance Academy. It is so, so incredible. Steph, I see you're on. Do you want to like pop in and give any additions?
Hey, hey. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Andrea?
Yeah, can you hear me?
Can you hear me?
Yes.
It's really bad. I'm driving. Yeah, I'm driving, so it's like pretty shoddy. Sorry, what did you say?
I just asked if there's anything you wanted to add.
It's not coming through.
All right, never mind. If you guys are interested in learning more about influence, there's a really great book. Let me look at the name. I just want to quote it to you, right?
Hey, is that better?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Oh, good. Hi.
Hi.
Were you asking if I had anything else to add?
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, nothing really official. I sort of the whole, I'm just going to do a little shout out on this whole like going to live events thing because it's been crazy for me in the sense of, you know, I'm like a personal development junkie now. My husband is just like, you're always reading. I'm like, damn straight. But it wasn't that I needed to work on, but it wasn't until I got into that room with everybody that it like really started opening myself up a bit. And so if any of you have an opportunity to go to a live event, like take it. Because it's been amazing for me. I mean, I came back to like a full swing of crazy work, and typically when I do that, I would come back from a whole thing of work. I'd get really stressed and sucked into the crazy day to day. And for the first time, I have been able to like consciously make myself aware that A, I need to stop midday and take a 5-minute meditation, and B, like when Thursday and Friday come around, when my week slows down, I'm going to be all in to go really hard and get my stuff done and not feel like I need to take a Netflix binge day to regroup and get rejuvenated again. Like it's been really good. And this whole concept that a power plant doesn't have power, it generates power.
Have energy.
Yes. So damn true. Like, and I've had to stop myself and like tell my, like, that has been my mantra all week of, I'm tired, I'm exhausted, my brain is break. No, I'm going to generate some more. Like, keep going. And it's a decision, like it really is, of how much do you want to get out of it it's a decision, and a conscious decision. And it's not something that I got on Sunday after the conference and it's like holding me through. It's a conscious decision that I am having to remind myself every single day. And that's big, because normally I would just kind of crumble and be like, it's too hard, it's too much. But yeah, I don't know. That's
So just to kind of touch on like the break piece and the energy piece. So there was like an entire day focused on nutrition and how you take care of your bodies at this event in order for you to be a high performer. And so that was something that I found really interesting because it increases your focus, it increases your energy. And one of the things that he says that if you can just do one thing for yourself, and that's every hour on the hour, take a break and do some deep breathing, like deep belly breaths, expanding and fully contracting your stomach, not breathing from your chest. 10 deep breaths like that floods your body with oxygen, refocuses you. It literally can take just a couple of minutes of a break and then come back to your work and you're actually more productive. And I used to be that person where I'm like, sit down, hunker down for 4 straight hours, just pound stuff out. By the end of it, mentally, I'm just like, and this whole week, every single hour I've been standing up. Yesterday I did one of my getting started rate calls as I was like pulling weeds in my backyard and like moving my body to keep my energy up. And I get to the end of my day and I feel amazing just by doing that one simple thing of like standing up and making a conscious choice to reflood my body with oxygen and energy. And so he says, like, going back to like confidence, you don't have confidence, you generate it, you make that choice. Same with energy. You don't have energy, you generate energy. And so he just pounded that into us all weekend long. And we would go from 9 a.m. till 7:30 at night. That's a long time to be learning. And every single hour during this, he made us stand up. And by the end of it, like, I felt so mentally crystal clear and good. We walked to go to dinner and it was incredible, that small shift. So if you guys are feeling like, oh, I just don't have the energy. Sometimes I would work my business after my kids were in bed, after my full-time job, when I first started my business. So I get, and I totally empathize with people who are like, oh, I'm just pooped. But you can make that conscious choice to just do some deep breathing. You can do some like patting on your skin because you just wake up your cells, but just by patting all over your whole body and doing some really, really deep breathing exercise. And all of a sudden it's like, oh, feels a little bit like a great cup of coffee. Whereas normally late at night, a cup of coffee ain't going to do nothing for you at that point. It's like you're drinking it more for comfort than you are for a jolt of caffeine because you're so depleted physically that. Okay. There's a question. So if someone says, I can't afford to join your challenge group, or we are really tight on budget, you would make it just be like, if it's something you really want, make it work. Okay, let me be very careful how I phrase this. You really have to understand that person. Because if you can tell that they're making excuses, I can smell an excuse from a mile away. I have a nose for it. If you are a little unsure, I'm not just going to be like, dude, get over yourself. Go find the money. I wouldn't say that. I was being a little blunt in my example. So let me see if I can come up with a better example for you. Actually, if you guys look in the how to interview a challenge guide or script that's on the Misfit site under the guides and scripts tab, at the bottom, it teaches you how to go through that and what to say. But I have said to people before, look, I totally understand how you feel. I felt that way too when I first started. But what I found was, like you, I wanted this so badly. I knew that I wanted to feel better and I knew I didn't want to take another month. So if you really need to go find the money, I totally understand and honor that. But I just want you to just ask yourself, is it that you don't have the money or is it that you're scared? And just ask the question and let people be honest and respond. And some people will say like, yeah, I'm scared this isn't going to work for me. And then you can alleviate that fear through story, just by sharing other examples of what has worked for other people, sharing other testimonials and success stories. Facts tell, stories sell. So it's relating with them and not telling them, not disregarding their initial objection. I totally understand how you feel. I felt that way too. Now you're connecting. You're honoring their initial feeling. And then you can say, but what I found was, and then share a story of how someone was able to go. Or you could say, but what I found was, I can use my coach, Nicole's example. What I found was my coach, Nicole, was so desperate for change in her financial life and needing something more that she actually went and pawned her wedding ring. I'm not telling you to go do that, but I'm just saying that you might want to take some time to think if there's a way that you can come up with that money. And if you want to make that change now. Now, when it comes to the business, here's what I do. If people say, look, I genuinely just need till payday, I'm like, perfect. I've got it on my calendar. What day do you want me to follow up with you? I ask them that question and they're going to say, I get paid this Friday, or I get paid next Friday, or I get paid on the 15th. I write their name down on my calendar and I say, perfect. I'm going to follow up with you then to help you get enrolled. But for now, here's what we can do so that we don't have to waste any time. And then I start sharing some of our Misfit training resources with them because I'm getting them to take action while they're motivated so that they can continue to build the momentum so that they don't lose it. So if people genuinely need time, or for example, if it's someone getting ready for a challenge group, you can say, perfect, I'm going to follow up with you on this day. But for now, I have this free 7-day clean eating recipe and shopping list. Here you go. Can we at least get started working on your clean eating? Getting them to take action so they don't lose that motivation in between the process of when they're actually going to pay gives you a higher result of going back to that person later on and saying, hey, I'm here to help you enroll. And then saying, perfect, I've been waiting for you. Okay, does that help anybody?
I also want to add on to that, because since obviously I was somebody who was very, very broke when I first started, and I share my story, and you're more than welcome to share mine. But I tell people, I'm like, exact same wording what Anne-Marie was saying, that, you know, the feel, felt, found method. And I tell people, I'm like, I found that I had to have that really tough conversation with my mom and my dad and really be open with them and tell them, like, look, I am tired, so sick and tired of borrowing money from you and being on state assistance every month. Can you please help me get started with this so I can not only feel better about me and not be so depressed anymore about where I'm at physically and emotionally, but I can also start taking care of my family independently and be financially independent from you, from the state, and from everyone else. I really lay that out there for people and let them know that I did. I mean, I went and called my mom and was like, I want to be an independent mother. I want to be an independent woman. Can you please help me so that I can finally start being independent from you? And that, having that conversation and letting people know that, and then letting them know, like, I'm so glad that I took that leap of faith, even though I was honestly scared and I hated having to have that conversation with my parents. But it has allowed me now to be independent. It has allowed me to be able to get off my depression medications. It's allowed me to now be able to support my family without depending on anyone else. So you're more than welcome to use my story as well if it, like, suits the person you're talking to.
Right.
You know, but I want to say that you have to be really real and honest with people like that are maybe that are struggling that much financially. I am very clear now. I wasn't maybe more so when I first started, but I'm learning more so now that you have to be very clear with them that, look, this is not going to get you out of your financial hole right in the very beginning. I'm not saying that you won't have great success in the beginning. You have to be really real with them and let them know that work has to be done, that they've really got to focus, because it took, for me, how much of a hole I was in financially, even though I was earning a little bit, it was not enough to take away financial aid. And hold on a second, baby.
and the money that I was borrowing every month. So you've got to be really honest with those people and let them know from the beginning. If you're really ready to do it and you're ready to have those kinds of tough conversations with people, maybe to get the money to start, great. But then know that when you start, you've really got to be working the business and really be consistent with it so that you can get to this point that you want to get at.
Right. You have to give people a clear plan and say, if you do XYZ, use the Misfit Planner to guide you. If you do XYZ on a daily basis, this is how you succeed. But you have to lay it out for them and teach them resolve, which is aligned with full engagement. There's a difference between I want to get out of debt and I am going to get out of debt. Can you guys hear the difference? The resolve and I am going to pay off my $100,000 worth of debt. That was me in the beginning. Not I hope or I want. That's a softer, more, it's a softer approach, and there's somewhere in there an opportunity of, oh, if it doesn't work out, no big deal, at least I tried. No, there is no trying with resolve. It's, I am going to do this. It does not matter what it takes. I am 100% fully engaged, all committed with joy and confidence in my business. There's a huge difference. Ask yourself what your resolve is towards your business too, because through your resolve, you'll teach people through your actions how to have that same resolve. Cool. Awesome, guys. Any last minute questions? We just have a few minutes left. You guys can unmute yourself too. Nope.
I'm hopping off right now. I just got to my mother-in-law's. I've got to get ready for my procedure this morning. But love you guys. It was a great call. Thank you for sharing all your knowledge.
See you later.
Bye.
Okay, Ellie says free groups. What ideas have worked for people? Does anybody else want to comment on the topic of free groups, of something that's been really successful for them? I know that we have some guides on the Misfit site.
Andrea, I can say something. I just did a group. This is for, oh my God, what month are we in? March, February group. It was a water and workout group, and it was so great. People loved it. It was really easy to do. There wasn't a whole lot of work on our end besides like checking in with people and really keeping up with it, but it was a simple, everyone, you know, you check in the morning, how much water you drink, check in the afternoon, how much water we drink. You gave like little like 5-minute workouts that they could do just to like do in the morning to get going. And it was really good. We got a lot of engagement. And I mean, I know the Clean Eden is always a good one, but this was another really good one that was super easy and people really enjoyed it. And people see really great results with it too. I mean, with just drinking a lot of water, I mean, I know with myself, it's a refresh, but it was always a really fun one.
Right. I've heard walking challenges too. Sometimes when you offer a prize, like I know, I think Nicole was telling me she did a walking challenge where everybody at the beginning, they invested $5. So they put skin in the game. And at the end, the people who had like tracked the most steps won the pot, or like top three people. So getting them to put a little skin in the game, I know it's a free challenge, so you can say it's optional, but you can't win the pot if you don't, you know, put $5 in. And then, or you could have a little prize at the end, say like if you check in every single day, give them like a Misfit tank or $5 Starbucks card or something like that. People like to win stuff. So having something that they can win always helps with engagement and getting people excited about it too. Poll the audience though. I love just asking my followers, what would you be interested in doing? And then giving them like, you know, 3 or 4 examples. And if they, you know, if the number one thing choice was this, I go back to those people and be like, perfect, I'm starting this. Or I've done personal development challenges too, where I'll take a book, I can't remember the name of it. Crap, it's not over there. Smart Money, Smart Kids. Dave Ramsey wrote a book called Smart Money, Smart Kids. So taking a personal development book, this is like the benefit extension thing again, where we're like, okay, this is going to help us lead by example in our finances, but we're also going to teach our kids something that was, people were like, heck yeah, I'd definitely be interested in stuff like that. So pull the audience. That's my best advice for that. Awesome, guys. Thanks for jumping on today. Does anybody have any special requests for next week or topics?